I'm here in the heart of Bristol today to talk to you about a very special person. Unlike you and me, he is so ignored by society that you could not notice him even if you were to try. He has in fact been walking beside me this entire time. Luckily, with fast advances in the advent of new fake technology, such as this lens, we can see this man for the very first time.
Fall is here, hear the yell, back to school, ring the bell, brand new shoes, walking blues, climb the fence, books and pens, I can tell that we are gonna be friends.
I'm getting old, my feathers are turning grey.
Yeah.
Want
to get a lens?
Yep, okay, go
on. Okay. Are you recording, Ben?
I'm rolling.
Still rolling?
Yeah.
Where's the script gone?
I've got it.
So, can you all see me?
Yep, thanks, Steve.
Well, this is a first. How should we start this off?
Why don't you introduce yourself?
Right, my name's Steve. I'm an imaginary friend, and I basically agreed to do this because, you know, I've come to the conclusion that it's not easy to be imaginary. A lot of people think it is.
So is that your job description then?
Well, technically my job is a commissioned surrogate sibling, but that's just bullshit. I'm an imaginary friend.
What sorts of clients do you get?
Mainly kids, you know, sort of the ones that get picked on in school, you know, all the annoying ones.
And were you always a chicken?
No, I have been a walrus on occasion.
A walrus?
Yeah, I've also been ducks, and I was once an emu. Yes. It depends on the client. I mean, different kids want different things.
Aha!
I've also been cover girls from Maxim.
What sort of kid would want those?
I also cater for teenagers as well. That can be fun.
And what about adults?
Yeah, unfortunately.
Peter's Steve's current client and has been for the past 20 years, and they both now live at this residence in Bristol. Steve was kind enough to allow our cameras in to follow a day in the life of this unique individual, unknown to the world until now.
Oh, Mr. Biggles, it's a wonderful day.
Is it? Is it really?
I call shotgun on the shower.
You bastard. Oh. Oh, out the way.
I take it you don't like Pete, then?
Well, Pete's an alright guy. It's just, it's more the job. I'm stuck in this dead-end job, and all my colleagues are working with children, and I'm stuck with this 25-year-old man. I mean, that's 15 extra years of baggage, and he's such a lonely git. It's... Sorry, man.
Mr. Biggles, can you possibly tell, please? Wait!
So, can't you leave him?
Unfortunately, I'm contractually bound to the guy if I want to get paid.
You could always work somewhere else that's well paid.
Like where? A bank?
Why not?
You ever seen a chicken working in a bank?
No, I...
Like what? Have you ever had a chicken dentist?
No.
Okay, the people point and they stare, okay? You know, it's... Did you actually think about these fucking questions before you asked?
Yeah. How long have you been drinking, Steve?
About Easter, 96. 7. Yeah, Easter's always a traumatic time of year for me.
Do you think you have a problem?
Goddamn right I have a problem, okay? It's Pete. The guy's 25 years old. He's driving me fucking crazy, alright? I can't escape. Sorry.
It's okay.
Milk's off. No eggs. Nasty. I'll get them up. You want it scrambled?
What would you say you do in an average day with Pete?
Well, your bugger just takes me around the university. I mean, it's not like he has any friends, so he takes me.
Why do you think no one talks to him?
I'm his only friend, okay? He talks to me. He's not a very sociable person, and the sad thing is, the longer he spends hanging around with me, the less chance he has of making any proper friends. And, you know, I tell him this, but he doesn't listen. You know, walking around university can be quite fun, you know. Other people can't see me, so, you know, I sometimes play little jokes on them.
Up the steps.
Do you do other things when you know people can't see you?
Occasionally. What sort of things do you mean?
Well, I don't know. Troublemaking, usual mischief.
Is Pete going to see this film?
Well, it's going to be on national TV, but please share.
I suppose I am a bit of a troublemaker then. I mean, I do mess with Pete. Sometimes.
Okay. Random studies. Random studies. Jack. Name commonly associated with beanstalks. But why did Jack climb a beanstalk? Was he not overwhelmed by the large height? Going back to my original lecture on Jack and the Beanstalk, why did Jack climb a beanstalk? Now, you may have heard the fairy tale, but there are strong links with surrealism in Jack and the Beanstalk. For example, magic beans, obviously, to lure the children into a sense of fairy tale madness. Pete!
What are you doing? Why are you reading my lesson? Every fucking lecture!
Had you thought that by doing that, you may in fact make him even more lonely and thus cause him to imagine you for even longer?
Yeah, but so what? I mean, it's funny.
Do you really believe that?
Look, okay, he deserves everything I throw at him. You know, he's 25, he should be able to manage on his own. I mean, the guy's talking to himself, he's a schizo.
But isn't he talking to you, Steve?
Yeah, but I'm not really here. What? You know, one of the best things about hanging around with Pete is he takes me to the library. It's one of the few interesting things we do together.
Thank you.
What do you hate the most?
I really hate the ban on fox hunting, okay? As a chicken, I think I speak for all chickens when I say...
No, I mean about Pete.
Well, what do I hate about Pete?
Don't be rude, Mr. Biggles. Do you want a chip?
Luckily, I don't condone cannibalism, but, you know, with desperation, anything's possible.
Now, Steve, how would you feel if we were to bring Pete in here right now to interview?
Absolutely not, okay? I specifically said this would be my side of the story. Whenever he would just turn... He would just make me look like the bad guy. He always does.
In the contract you signed, Steve, it did in fact state that part of the documentary would be a conversation between you and Pete.
Well, that's it. I'm sorry. Interview over, okay? I can't... It's useless, okay? You know you're in a dead-end job when your employer's... control space and time. I mean, I can't bloody leave, okay? It's in the contract I signed, you know, I can't be free until he forgets about me. And that ain't gonna happen anytime soon.
Have you ever tried anything else to escape? Perhaps talking to Pete about the problem?
Yeah, I've tried that, but... Okay, I'm his imaginary friend, okay? If we're having an argument, he doesn't like what I'm saying, he just imagines that I stop talking and I can't get a word in edgeways. I tried jumping off a building once. That didn't work, I hit the ground, bounced a little. A few scratches, that was it, okay? And another time I tried to hang myself.
Hang yourself?
And, you know, I was left dangling there for 3 hours, okay? When Pete finally comes in, he doesn't help me, he just uses me as a fucking piñata, okay?
That's terrible.
Can I have a drink, please?
Yeah, someone get him a drink. Yeah. That's terrible. Really awful.
Yeah, but, I've gotten used to it now.
You must find this imprisonment discomforting.
Yeah, it's uncomfortable, I mean... Well, I mean, it's not as if I don't love Pete. I mean, you know, contractually obliged to, but it's just the future that bothers me. You see, you know, he's 25 now. There's no telling how much longer I could be stuck with him. I just don't know how much longer it's going to be like this. You know, and frankly, I don't want to be helping him with his Zimmer frame when he's 75. You know, this is my life as well, you know. You know, I just get the feeling that, you know, I have ambitions, hopes and dreams just like everybody else, but, you know, I just don't get to realise them.
Do you feel you're wasting your life?
Yes and no. I mean, there are certainly a lot better things I could be doing with my life, but, you know, I wouldn't say it's not without its perks. I mean, as I said earlier, I get to, you know, I'm a bit mean to him sometimes and I get to push him around.
What would you like to do with your life, Steve?
I don't know, I suppose at the end of the day I'd just like to be happy. And, I know I'm no spring chicken, but I'd quite like to, you know, start a family, raise some eggs somewhere, you know, nice little house in the country. I'd just like the opportunity to be able to meet the right kind of hen.
As a chicken?
I don't really think of myself as a chicken. I've been a chicken for so long now, it's all I know, okay? I mean, sure, I could be a walrus. You know, a walrus would be fun. But this is what I know, okay? I've been a chicken for so long that I actually now find hens more sexually attractive than any other animal.
Well, then that's great, Steve. Yeah. I think we have enough material now. Thank you for your time, Steve.
Thank you. I'm sorry if I got a little bit emotional.
No problem, Steve.
When do I get paid for all of this?
Oh, we'll send you a letter.
Pete's waiting outside, so thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Steve.
Oh, God damn it.